Today, I want to show you how you can convert your PowerPoint presentation into a PDF. This is a great way to share your presentation with your audience without allowing them to modify the original presentation. It's also a great way to share your presentation on the web. At the very end, I'll show you a bonus trick. It's somewhat of a hidden feature that allows you to email a PDF of your presentation with just one click. All right, let's check this out. Here I am in Microsoft PowerPoint, and to turn this presentation into a PDF, let's go up to the top left-hand corner and click on the File menu. Within File, let's go down to the Export option. At the top of Export, you'll see the option for PDF/XPS. That's the one we want, so let's click on Create. This opens up a prompt where you can specify where you want to save your PDF. Down below, you can type in a file name, and you can also choose the quality level. You have Standard. This is the top level of quality, but it'll also take up more space. You also have Minimum. The quality will be a little bit worse, but it'll also take up less file space. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see a button that says Options. What would life be like without options? Let's click into there to see what we can do. Within Options, at the very top, I can define what slides I want to include in my PDF. First, I could just include all of my slides, so the entire presentation. Or here, I could select the current slide, so if I just want one slide to make up my PDF. On the side, I also have something called Selection. With Selection in my deck, I can press the Control key, and let's say I select slides 1, 3, and 6, well, I could choose just to include those. I also have the option to include a custom show, and down below, I can select a slide range. But with this, I won't be able to skip any slides. So if I enter in 2 through 6, well, I can't skip any in between. If I want to skip any slides, I should use the selection option. Down below, I also have some publish options. With slides, it'll just include the slide as a page. I also have the option for handouts, and with this, I can include multiple slides on a page. Next up, we also have the notes view. This will show the slide and any associated notes. And lastly, I can also include the outline view. Down below, there are some additional options, and you can check them on or off as you like. PowerPoint offers many different ways to create a PDF, and I'll show you two more. You can also go to the File menu, click on Save As, and here under the file type, you can select PDF. If you want to get back to all of those same options, down below you can click on More Options, then click on Options again, and here you can configure what your PDF looks like. And yet another way, once again, let's go up to the File menu, go down to Print, and here under the Printer, you can choose Microsoft Print to PDF. And here too, you can also export as a PDF. With all of that now out of the way, I want to show you the bonus trick that allows you to email your presentation as a PDF with just one click. To do this, we need the Quick Access toolbar. If you don't yet have that turned on, you can right-click on the ribbon up above and you can toggle on or off your Quick Access toolbar. Once you see the Quick Access toolbar, let's right-click in there and then select Customize. This opens up PowerPoint options, and in the first drop-down list, let's set it to All Commands. And this shows us a massive list of different commands that we can add to the Quick Access toolbar. And let's scroll down until we find the option that says Email as PDF Attachment. Once again, I know it's a long list. It'll take a little bit to find this, but hey, at least everything's in alphabetical order. Once you find the option, click on the Add button and you'll see it move over to the right-hand side. Then click on OK. Back on the main PowerPoint screen, in your Quick Access toolbar, you'll see that there's now a new icon. And when you click on that, it opens up a new email message with your presentation attached as a PDF. That's pretty slick, and it makes it really easy to share your presentation with others. All right, well, you are now a PDF expert in PowerPoint. To see more videos and tutorials like this one, check out the playlist right up above. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.